Okay, some of you, well, actually, quite a few of you have requested that I review slash give you my thoughts on the Force Unleashed series. So without further ado, let's attempt to keep this, short and sweet. The Force Unleashed revolves around the training of a secret Sith apprentice to the Dark Lord Darth Vader in the period between episodes 3 and 4. The Force Unleashed details the systematic hunting down and, killing of several Jedi, as well as the beginnings of the Rebel Alliance, which opposed Palpatine's Empire in the classic film trilogy. The graphics are highly polished, the music is very well crafted, and the game is fun to play, if you enjoy hack-and-slash God of War-style video games. And that's about all the positive things I can say for this game. The Apprentice, Galen Merrick, aka Starkiller, comes across as a huge contrivance to me, and really doesn't seem necessary. You always heard the tale that Darth Vader hunted down the Jedi Knights, not that he manipulated some young fool into doing it for him. Galen Merrick is tasked with the duty to kill various Jedi who escaped Order 66 by Vader, but he's supposed to do this in secret in accordance with the Rule of Two so that Palpatine doesn't find out. As a result, you often have to kill many Imperial forces as well as the ones of the Jedi and the budding Rebel Alliance forces. Along the way, he randomly falls in love with a pilot named Juno Eclipse, and she's likely the first hot chick he's ever seen before in his life, and so suddenly we're supposed to buy into the notion that he's a misunderstood guy. I mean, come on, he's like trained in the arts of the dark side since he was a child. I don't understand why he is taking this path. It's very odd. But I suppose they're trying to make him seem a bit more personable, make the story a bit more heroic. But it could have been far less cliche, and even if this was the route they were going to go with, they should have given him more of a personality if they wanted me to buy into this. Eventually, Galen is betrayed and nearly killed by Vader, and is brought back to health by his master, but now the seeds of doubt have been planted, and Merrick isn't so sure if he wants to continue in the line that he is, down the path that he has been forced upon. Merrick seeks out a Jedi Master he nearly killed a few weeks prior on Vader's orders and enlists his help in forming the Rebel Alliance. This is done to lure all of the budding leaders of the Rebel Alliance into a singular location where the Sith Lords can wipe them out once and for all. And Galen succeeds in doing this. He lures them all into a singular location where they finally unite under a common banner and swear to take down the Galactic Empire. And long story short, he is once again betrayed by Vader and takes the fight directly to him and the Emperor on board the Death Star thereafter. After much fighting, Vader is injured and Palpatine proceeds to engage Merrick in a final confrontation. Here's where the game allows you to choose whether you'd like to be good or evil. If you finish off Vader, then you become Palpatine's new apprentice, but only after being disfigured yourself after attacking the more powerful Dark Lord. If you attack Palpatine, you are eventually defeated, but you succeed in giving the Rebel leaders enough time to escape. This is hands down the best part of the game for me. The self-fulfilling prophecy element here, the aspect of the Emperor's brilliant plan going awry, I really enjoyed the way this tied up the game, and it really made it make sense. In the process of attempting to use the allegedly secret apprentice to track down the Rebel leaders, Palpatine's plot fails when he isn't able to succeed in killing them all. Not only that, but it is because of his manipulations that they were formed and united together against a common enemy in the first place. And when he kills Galen Merrick, he gives the Alliance a martyr and to rally around, which really strengthens their resolve to their cause even further. That was the moment I'd been waiting for the whole game, the reason for why this story was being told at all. I didn't understand why this was a necessary story, and in many ways it isn't. But they were able to make a coherent tie-in to the films in a way that I thought was very meaningful, considering the bland nature of the story and the overall unimpressive character arc of Galen Merrick himself. Unfortunately, this is ruined in large part by the ridiculously transparent effort on Lucas's part when they decide to create a sequel to the game, which only muddles the already tenuous story and serves as an obvious cash crop. But we'll talk about that game another time. To put it simply, the Force Unleashed series as a whole is a cash crop, which employs gameplay mechanics from other popular titles of modern games and sticks them in the Star Wars universe. It relies on an over-the-top and unrealistic presentation of the Force, and the abilities are demonstrated through a character who is difficult to care about due to his very bland personality and cliched and unrealistic motivation found in the very superficial love story of this game. The representation of the Force itself is simultaneously a blessing and a curse. It's very fun to use when you play through the game, and it's quite a spectacle when compared to the all-too-subdued nature of the Force within the actual films. However, at the same time, I can't shake the feeling that the developers actually took things too far with the scale of things here. They needed to really reel it in a bit. Their ideas just sort of blossomed into ideas that just aren't feasible and feel very out of place in the Star Wars mythos. The lightsaber duels are very fun and cinematic, although I feel that they are a bit out of place in the Star Wars universe as well when you look at how they're handled. At times the voice acting is quite good, but others it's very plain and boring. The combat will appeal to those who enjoy button mashing, and the story comes across as one note, and one that didn't really need to be told, but was handled fairly well, all things considered. Odd characters like Proxy will either feel like a strange quirk and enhance the game's charm, or they will be seen as an annoyance, frankly. Appearances from characters like Bail Organa, Shaak-Ti, Princess Leia, they're all welcome, but they don't really do much to enhance the game's too short and predictable plotline. The game is fun, but it's nothing really revolutionary, nor is it something that is very true to Star Wars lore. I do own this game, I still play it, I don't have any plans to sell it, but in my heart, I really cannot consider myself a fan of this franchise. This game is a far cry from the insanely fun ride that the Jedi Knight series was. It pales in comparison to the action-adventure of the Battlefront series. It's nothing short of embarrassing when compared to masterpieces like the Knights of the Old Republic games or Republic Commandos. So there you are, those are my thoughts on The Force Unleashed. You've got my opinion now, you can take it or leave it. Don't take my criticisms to heart if you enjoy this game. I simply wasn't very impressed. Mostly because I just didn't feel like this was a story that begged to be told, and it's hard for me to care about the character since he's very, very boring in my opinion. But it is still a bit fun. If I were to grade this game on a scale from 1 to 10, I'd probably give it a 6.5 maybe. I don't know, maybe even a 7, just because it was really fun to play in this sort of surreal, ultra-powerful, you know, environment, but it's just got some issues as far as the technical execution of this game is concerned. It's too short, and it's really not very, it's just not really anything new. It's really not, and I can't really appreciate it on the same level as a lot of other fans do. So yeah, those are my thoughts. You guys have them now. Hope I didn't offend anyone with my statements, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.